The feed draper takes the crop from the side drapers and delivers it to the feed auger. The drive roller has a non-slip vulcanized coating applied for superior traction. There are three grease points for the feed draper rollers. Two on the idler roller at the front, and one on the rear roller on the rear right side. The grease interval is every 10 hours. The feed draper tension is adjusted from underneath the header. The U shape in the middle of this assembly is the tension indicator. However, the indicator does not have to be centered for tension to be correct. The adjustment can be up to 3 millimeters loose, which is aft of center of the U, or 6 millimeters tighter, which is forward of center of the U. Adjustment does not have to be the same on each side. The tension is factory set and then adjusted as needed so the feed draper tracks straight. Adjustments can be made if the center draper is slipping, but always observe how the draper is tracking after making an adjustment. The bottom feed deck pan is a thick formed poly to prevent seed loss and easily opens for clean out and inspection. The feed auger feeds the cut crop from the draper decks into the combine feeder house. The feed auger can be configured in a number of different ways with a combination of flighting and fingers to maximize feeding for your combine. There are recommended setups for each combine brand, but if conditions dictate, fingers or flighting may be installed or removed. The auger is mechanically driven via a shaft and chain from the header drive main gearbox. There's a mechanical slip clutch to protect the feed auger if it comes into contact with an unharvestable object. There are two lubrication points for the feed auger pivots. They are located at the rear of the float module, above where the multicoupler attaches. The feed auger drive chain requires inspection at the first 10 hours of operation, then inspect and lubricate every 100 hours thereafter. To check the chain tension, rotate the auger by hand in reverse direction to take up the slack in the chain. Mark a reference line across the auger and cover. Rotate the auger by hand in forward direction to take up the slack and make a second reference line on the cover from the line on the auger. Measure the distance between the two lines on the cover. For a new chain, a distance of 1 to 4 millimeters requires no adjustment. Less than that, the chain is too tight, and more than that, and the chain is too loose. Proceed with adjustment. For a used chain, if the distance between the marks is 3 to 8 millimeters, no adjustment is required. Outside 3 to 8 millimeters requires adjustment. To adjust tension, loosen the jam nut. Loosen the idler nut slightly to allow the idler to move before turning adjuster. Rotate the auger in reverse to take up the slack in the chain. Turn adjuster thumb screw clockwise to increase tension until rotational movement of auger is correct. When adjustment is complete, tighten the jam nut. Tighten the idler nut and torque to 258 to 271 newton meters. The feed auger finger timing can be changed with an adjustment on both sides of the auger. This feature determines where the fingers are fully extended. There are two options. Position A is used for canola and other bushy crops, and the fingers are fully extended earlier in the rotation. Position B is used for most other grains. Both sides must be adjusted to the same position, or damage to the auger will occur. When the combine feeder house is reversed, a clutch inside the auger changes the position of the fingers so they extend on the feeder house side of the auger. This allows the auger to pull the crop back under the auger and onto the feed draper. When the combine feeder house is returned to the forward operation, the clutch shifts the fingers back to the normal operating position. Inside the auger is a magnetic shield to prevent debris from damaging the reversing clutch. The feed auger has two operating options, floating or rigid. Headers are set in the floating position from the factory. The rigid position may be beneficial if feeding issues arise in light, fluffy crops like canola or field peas. This adjustment is made underneath the header. Beneath the auger is a stainless steel feed pan. The auger to feed pan clearance needs to be checked every 100 hours. If the clearance is too tight, the flighting or fingers may rub on the feed pan. Too loose, and the crop may hesitate before entering the feeder house, creating a slug. With the cutter bar 250 to 300 millimeters off the ground extend the tilt cylinder to position E. Check the auger float position to determine how much clearance is required. If the bolt head is closest to the floating symbol, the auger is in the floating position. The clearance required between the auger flighting and the feed pan should be 12 to 16 millimeters. If the bolt head is closest to the fixed symbol, the auger is in the fixed position. The clearance required between the auger flighting and the feed pan is 24 to 28 millimeters. Make sure bolts are set to the same location on both ends of the auger to prevent damage during operation. To adjust the clearance, loosen the two nuts on each side of the feed auger. Turn the bolt clockwise to increase the clearance or counterclockwise to decrease clearance. After adjustment, tighten and torque the nuts to 93 to 99 Newton meters. When replacing an auger finger, make sure that the R-clip is installed correctly. The closed end of the clip should face in the direction of auger rotation. Damaged finger holders can be replaced without dismantling the auger by installing a two-piece holder assembly.